get started, I'm glad each and every one of you are here. We're going to have a good time today. There's three things we're doing that I love to do. One is to drive cars, cool cars. We're going to go fishing, and we're going to eat some great food. So we're going to have a good time today.
How about drink?
I was in charge of the weather. It's going to be great, so.
You did your part.
If it's not, it's Maria's fault.
Yes.
No. We are good. I want to introduce a few people, and then we'll do our presentation, and then afterwards, I'll do a few housekeeping measures, okay, about what we're doing today. First off, Nathan Snedden. He works,
Nathan.
He's in product planning and works on the Rogue Sport. He's going to be doing a walk around here shortly outside of the Rogue Sport. Also, Janelle Grigsby joins us from the West Coast. She's our newest member of the Communications But Janelle's the newest member. She's our West Coast Regional PR manager out there, brand new. She's wonderful. I met her yesterday for the first time. But she's going to be a great addition to the Nissan team. And she has a wonderful hat she's going to wear today, along with Miss Angelica. So they will be sporting fine hat attire. And then also introducing Aditya Dirich. He is in the... microphone over, even though I don't have a microphone, to Aditya, who's going to go through the deck that you have there in front of you. We don't have PowerPoint, but we've got a hard copy deck for you. So he's going to go through that and talk about the Rogue Sport. And at any time, if you have a question while he's going through it, please feel free to ask. We'll keep this fairly casual. So now I turn it over to Aditya.
Thanks, Steve.
You bet.
All right, so you guys have seen the deck.
Yes.
And I'm the fluffy marketing guy. This is going to do my speed and kind of convince you guys that this car is going to do well. Now, I'll tell you this. We started selling about 40 days ago. And so far, the last 40 days, it's done great. I can say this, it has exceeded our expectations in the last 40 days. Now, whether it will continue to exceed our expectations, time will tell. Right, so... just a few things. I'm not going to talk about each and every slide out here, but I'll just focus on, I think, some factors that I think will be key and some factors that we think are crucial in the success of the Rogue Sport. And it's not all focused on just the Rogue Sport, but it's also focused on the segment, what is happening in terms of customer preferences, and also in terms of how we got the Rogue Sport out here. It's not an unknown car. It's sold in Europe as the Qashqai. It's Nissan's number one selling crossover in Europe. So it's proven, it's been optimized, and it's been brought to the US. All right, so, okay, unfortunately we don't have slide numbers, but I'll just show you guys what slide I'm talking about.
I think it's the first
slide.
First one.
Right, so 2016 was a fantastic year for Nissan. Right, so with a 5.5% increase in sales, we're the fastest growing automotive brand in the US. Things are going well for us. But to focus on crossovers specifically, we grew 5.5% in 2016, but crossovers grew by 16%. Right? No guesses. Everyone is shifting from sedans to crossovers. Altima, which used to be our best selling model, in November of last year, the Nissan Rogue actually picked up the crown spot. So we are keeping pace with the industry, and in some manners actually outpacing the industry too. I'm moving to the next page right now. This is the page I'm on. Right, so just touching a little bit about the Rogue. Right, so the Rogue, you guys have seen for a while. The first Rogue was launched in 2007. We've sold over 1.5 million Rogues. So lots of units in operation. In other parts of the world, the Rogue is called the X-Trail. So again, we sell it in the US, we sell it in the other parts of the world too. But, in 2017, a few months ago, we launched the all-new Rogue. So, some changes to the fascia, some changes inside. Very good reception to the minor change that we launched. And there are substantial number of millennials who are buying. And for the rock sport, millennials are going to be an important customer base. It's not just going to be millennials, it's going to be different people who are in the stage of, you know, different stages of life. So millennials may or may not have kids, could be single, they just need enough space, they don't want their cars to be too big. So boom, the rock sport is for them. And then you've also got the, what I call the older millennials. So when I say the older millennials, I mean people who are older, but in the same stage of life as millennials are. So you might be, whatever, 50, 55, 60, your kids may be in college, you know, you don't need that much space anymore, but you've still been driving, you still want to drive an SUV, but you want a smaller one. So a rock sport might be what you're looking for, because it's an SUV, gives you the feel that you're driving a sedan, but gives you the versatility of a crossover. Right? So I think I caught everybody in this room here a millennial, so.
Thank you.
Alright.
Thank you.
Switching gears now. So I'm on this side.
Only one.
Right? This is the side I'm on right now. What I'm trying to focus on here is that with the Rogue Sport actually entering our stable, Nissan is catering to the shift from sedans to crossover. So we've got in our portfolio a crossover that meets everybody's demands. So you know, again, I'll read out of here, you know, whether you want a small entry crossover, the Rogue Sport is for you. You're an empty nester, your household income is a little bit higher, you've got the nicely spec'd out Murano. Again, if you're looking for a family SUV, two kids, you need some space, the Rogue is what will fit your bill. A little larger one, we've got the Pathfinder, and then we've got the Armada, which is the full-size SUV. So we kind of cover the entire gamut where we are able to cater to customers in different stages of their life to their different needs in their life. All right, I'm going to skip the next page, which is an overview of the 2017 Rogue that we spoke about, but I'm going to jump quickly to this page. Right, it's very crucial to understand who our competition is. So again,
what competition?
There you go. I needed to say that.
No.
No, but you know, in terms of competition, it's a new segment. Again, this compact SUV segment is pretty large. It constitutes, give or take, 20+% of the TIV right now. But within this compact SUV segment, we're seeing different mini segments. Right? So within these mini segments, again, it's driven based on the space in the car. So the Rogue Sport, you know, perhaps is somewhere middle of the line in this compact SUV segment. You know, the smaller one maybe could be the segment in which, you know, the CHR, the Toyota CHR operates, or you know, where the Juke operates. So it's kind of a little smaller. And then you've got the Rogue, right? And then you've got, then you have the Rogue Sport, and then you have the Rogue. So in terms of competition, what we've seen, you know, the Sportage, HR-V, the Mazda CX-3, these could be the cars that we are cross-shot with. So again, in terms of the product we have, looking at a competition, I think we've got a great value proposition for customers. Alright, next page. This is where I'm on. This is the perfect marketing page, where the marketing guy comes here and talks about stuff that he has absolutely no idea about. But, so the way we kind of, you know, positioned this was, what are needs of customers, and where does the Rogue belong, and where does the Rogue Sport belong? So for example, you know, those without kids, that's the last bar that you see here. Now we think that Rogue Sport is a car that you might buy if you don't have kids, right? And then the Rogue is a perfect car if you have kids. Again, it's that little bit more space that makes a difference. And Nathan will be going through the difference between Rogue and Rogue Sport in the walkaround. So you'll know how much shorter it is. But given the change in dimensions, you know, the cargo space only reduces by a small amount. So again, with kids, without kids is a differentiator between Rogue and Rogue Sport. This last but one line at the bottom, youthful and mature. May or may not agree with that completely, but we're saying that you'll probably buy a Rogue Sport if you're youthful. And you'll probably buy a Rogue if you're mature. Again, being youthful has no correlation with age. You could be 75 years old and you could still be very youthful. So, not categorizing based on age. And again, the first column there is on city versus suburbs, right? So, the rope sport gives you good versatility, good handling, good ride comfort, good maneuverability. So, maybe it depends on what your usage is, but probably more for the cities compared to the suburbs. So again, this is just a comparison that we set out in terms of how the rogue and the rogue sport differentiate each other from one another. All right, so we provided all these features in this cars. Now when I say all these features, you get all the safety specs that are available on the rogue, are also available in the rogue sport. We make no differentiation in that. The fit and finish, you guys will see, the product quality is as good as the Rogue, if not better. So it's not, you know, it's not kind of cutting corners, because this customer is crucial, this customer is demanding, and this customer knows what to expect. So we're doing all this, and our starting price is 21,420. So it's positioned in such a way that, you know, we might also be able to conquest some customers who now typically buy sedans, right? So that's a customer base we're looking at who might make the switch. So that was my marketing spiel. Hope I didn't put anyone to sleep as yet. It's still early in the morning. If you have any questions, happy to take questions here or take it outside, whatever you guys wish for.
What's the base price for the Rogue?
The difference is 2,500. Well, 3,000.
To be 18,000.
Well, no more, it'll be 24,000.
No,
so Rogue is 24,420 and the Rogue Sport is 21,420. Rogue Sport is cheaper, that is correct. Rogue Sport is cheaper than the Rogue.
Less expensive.
Less expensive.
Thank you.
There you go. Thank you,
you
for that.
And then I'm kidding.
Full experience. Why not?
Yeah. All right, they'll clean the fish and then we'll take him to Lazy Days, which is right next to Buzz Arena's. And they will prepare the fish for us there, okay?
Really?
Yes. Really? And then we'll eat, and then we'll get in the cars and come back. If there's leftover fish, we're going to try and let you take home some of the fish that you've caught. So we've got coolers and ice, so you'll be able to take home the fish. Hopefully we can do that. I think there's no problem with that, but that's what we're efforting to try and do for you as well. Any questions on the fishing trip there? All right. Once we're done at Lazy Days, the cars will all be parked at Lazy Days. Your crew, Luis and Pablo, you'll get in one of the Rogue Sports, y'all get another Rogue Sport, and then the rest of you get in the rest of the vehicles. You all are welcome just to drive straight back. It's about an hour and 15 minutes coming back, the rest of you, okay? Just to get you there. I know we're gonna do something special for you, Pepe, to get you back, so no problem there. Any questions? All right, take everything with you. We're gonna go outside here. What I would recommend is go ahead and use the restroom.
Yes.
Before we go, the restrooms are right outside. Take everything with you. You will need to take it with you because this room is gonna be closed up and you won't be able to get access to it. So take it with you. Any questions?
In your car.
All right, fantastic. We'll see you outside.